We move to the third, and Maddux is the leadoff man against Wood. He is, as you know, a good hitting pitcher. He hit 240 this year. In addition to everything else they do well, the Braves starting pitchers are good hitters. Smoltz, Glavin, Maddux, they can all help themselves.
Bob, I just made a major faux pas.
What was that?
My scorecard blew out into the stands. I can't believe it. The wind just grabbed it.
And so the question now is, it's just like a Sosa or McGuire home run ball. Does the fan believe that it belongs to you, and does he give it up out of a sense of duty, or does he sell it to the highest bidder?
Well, I saw the young lady. She pointed that she was going to bring it up.
Two and two. Now we'll see what she asks in return. Maddux whacks one toward left center field. Johnson on the run, can't get there. Can he hold him to a single? Maddux is thinking double, running hard. In there. Has to hold onto the bag for dear life as he almost overslid it. Then he asks for time. What a good athlete he is.
He is a good athlete, but like you mentioned, and all the Braves pitchers are pretty good hitters. Fastball, that ball was in a little bit, and Maddux was able to find center field. They had him shaded around the right center, and he hustles in. Watch this slide. That's a fadeaway slide there by Maddux, and he's safe at second base.
Now Walt Weiss, who singled to start the game. The Braves have put their leadoff man on all three turns at bat against Wood. Maddux at second with a leadoff double. Gaetti inching in at third. Weiss looks to bunt and fouls it off.
And one of the difficult things to do against a hard thrower is to bunt the ball and direct it where you want. And in most cases, if you're trying to keep a guy from bunting and you throw hard like Wood does, you throw the high fastball. You may get him to pop it up.
Checks Maddux and brings it home on 0-1. Strike two as Weiss can't get it down.
Just as hard to bunt it as it is to hit it sometimes. You've got to get the barrel out front and wait and then just play catch. Well, he doesn't have a lot of bunting space there, and you can see he's swinging at it and pushing at it. You can't do that. You may have a better chance of trying to pull it on the ground.
Line back to Wood, and Maddux scampers back to second.
Good base running there by Greg Maddux at second base. Wood throws the fastball. Weiss trying to pull it, lines it back to Wood. And he immediately looks at second base. But Maddux, good base running, does not venture off too far.
Now they'll face Keith Lockhart, who fouled out in the first.
They've got a pretty good scouting report on the Braves. I'm watching how they're pitching their hitters. Certain guys on this, Lockhart, Weiss, Andrew Jones, real good fastball hitters. They're starting them off and throwing them a lot of breaking balls when they can stay ahead in the count.
Brace will take it himself. Maddux to third, but with two out.
And that was another breaking ball, slider down.
Now it's up to Chipper Jones, who flied to center in the first.
He made some great pitches on Chipper in the first and a couple breaking balls in under the hands, then got him out with a changeup down and away.
Fastball inside. It remains true of Chipper Jones that almost all of his power is from the left side. He got the game-winning hit in game two right-handed. But 32 of his 34 home runs were hit lefty this year. A ball and a strike. This next pitch will be Wood's 50th. As we mentioned, Jim Riggleman has him slated, if all goes well, for somewhere between 90 and 100. Down low, 2-1. No score, top of the third. Maddux at third with two out. Got the corner.
It's a good hard slider off on the inside corner. Starts in the middle of the plate and jumps at him. Pitch started right in the middle of the plate and then just broke sharply in.
This one gets away from Houston, and coming to the plate is Maddux for the game's first run.
Well, we'll have to see how that was scored. I thought Houston should have been able to block the ball, but we'll... Because with another slider, and that ball there is in the air, that is definitely a pass ball. The ball was off of Houston's right kneecap. Watch, it'll be right at his right kneecap, and he should catch that ball. Hits right off the end of the glove for a pass ball.
And it is scored as a pass ball. And now Jones whacks one into center field. It falls for a hit.
Well, they've thrown Chipper so many off-speed pitches, he finally just cuts down on his swing and flips one into center field for a base hit.
You can talk all you want about the merits, whatever they may be, of the designated hitter rule.
And people are there merits?
Not many. And people who are too bored with baseball to put up with watching a pitcher bat. But when you have a pitcher who can help himself, like Maddux, and Wood is a good hitting pitcher, but when you have to think about pinch hitting, or do you sacrifice or not, it adds texture to the game. Maddux came through with a double, and with good base running, managed to help himself and take the lead here in the third inning.
And you mentioned the entire Braves starting rotation. They work at their hitting, they work at their base running, they work at their sacrifice. They're just good athletes.
Here is the big merit of the designated hitter rule.
Okay.
Especially when it first came in. It allowed guys like Kaline, Oliva, people like that, to stick around longer, fan favorites. And there are some guys, Eddie Murray was an example, able to prolong their careers. But you don't need it for extra offense anymore, as they did in the early 70s, because offense has exploded all around baseball. Galarraga fouls it away.
Well, to be honest with you, I don't think there's any doubt that the designated hitter really helped the American League, you know, when they implemented it, because it did keep some of the stars around, and I think it added some more excitement to the game. And they've scored more runs in the American League than the National League because of it.
But it really takes the strategy away, a lot of it. Makes the game less interesting overall. One-two pitch to the big cat. Misses. Since Chipper Jones followed Tyler Houston's pass ball with a base hit, it makes the runoff Wood earn in this inning. Had he retired Jones, the run would have been unearned because of the pass ball.
That's one of the theories of baseball I don't like.
They check it first. They say he didn't go. Full count.
With Maddux at third, they may have made a different pitch. A lot of things could have happened differently. And you can see that Galarraga checks his swing.
The runner goes, and a swing and a miss, finishing Galarraga and the Atlanta third. Third strikeout for Wood, but he's behind Maddux, one zip.
Somewhere there's a job where you can take time off for a cold. But until you find that job, there's Halls Mentholyptus to soothe your throat and calm your cough. Halls, we'll go into work.
feel the refreshment of Surt's powerful mints. Like skinny dipping. In Fargo. In February. Surt's powerful mints. With Retsin. Keep your powerful cool longer.
Chevy Tahoe with a Vortec engine. The most powerful SUV anywhere.
A lot of financial companies can make you feel awfully small and unimportant.
I was hoping to get some help.
Down the hall.
Ask her.
Do you have an appointment?
Can you come back later?
Ask her.
Excuse me, I was wondering.
No, I'm sorry, I can't help you.
But you won't feel that way talking to a MetLife financial professional. You'll get personal face-to-face advice and information on mutual funds and annuities, as well as insurance. And no matter what size your portfolio, you'll have a friend for life. Get Met. It pays.
Well, well, look at you. You are one good-looking pizza.
Me? No, my friend. You are the good-looking pizza.
Please, don't be modest. Look at those toppings.
Why, my toppings? Forget about it. Look at your toppings. Pepperoni, green pepper. Wait, is that onion?
Yeah, I got a little onion.
You're killing me.
Well, look at you, Mr. Ham.
Oh.
Mr. Mushroom. Mister, could you possibly fit any more pepperoni on me?
No, stop. Get in the bag.
Get two Little Caesars pizzas featuring our authentic 1959 recipe and three toppings for just $10.99.
Pizza, pizza.
Defending champion David Duvall, Justin Leonard, Tom Lehman, Payne Stewart, and more. The Michelob Championship at Kings Mill, next weekend on NBC.
In the old scoreboard atop the bleachers in dead center field, they put up the one for the Atlanta Braves in the top half of the third. Kerry Wood starts it against Maddux and takes a strike. This is not the oldest ballpark in the majors. Fenway and Tiger Stadium are each older. Wood hits it to Lockhart, who throws him out, and we throw it to Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much, Bob. I'm now joined by the Commissioner of Baseball, Bud Selig. Bud, you have now presided over a great baseball season. Has there been a better season than 1998, in your opinion?
Well, you know, a lot of people are convinced of that, and Jim, other than the summer of 49, which I have a great historical fondness, I believe this may have been the greatest year in baseball history. It has been so remarkable in so many ways.
What stands out? Is it the Yankees and all their victories in the American League, Mark McGwire, Sammy Sosa? What one moment, if you can pick one, stands out this year for you?
Well, there are a lot of things, and you've just named them, but the Mark McGwire, Sammy Sosa situation, and being in St. Louis when he hit the 62nd home run, given the sense of history and everything else, it's one of those moments that those of us there, and I'm sure those that watched, will never forget.
Lance Johnson just tagged out. Mickey Morandini now at the plate. Let me ask you about Sammy Sosa. He gets 66 home runs, and he's not going to be in the record book. Is there any special thing that you might do as Commissioner, Bud, to commemorate his achievement as well as McGwire's?
Well, he'll be in the record book, obviously, only because he passed Babe Ruth and Roger Maris's record. But, yes, we do have big plans, frankly, during the World Series to honor both of them in a very unique and a very special way. And Sammy deserves all the credit in the world.
All right, Bud, we appreciate your time. We look forward to chatting with you throughout the American League Championship Series as we head to the Braves. At the top half of the inning, the Braves hit 1-0.
It's unbelievable. Ford's factory authorized clearance has been extended, and you've got one last chance to get low 0-9 financing plus $750 to $1,000 cash on new 98 ZX2s, Escorts, Contours, Rangers, and Tauruses. One more chance for low 1-9 financing on 98 F-150s, 0-9 on 98 Explorers, or 0-9 or 1,500 cash on 98 Windstars. It's your last chance. Plus, check out the great deals on the newly arriving 99s. Get to your local Ford store's factory authorized clearance today.
The more challenging the path, the more rewarding the life. the real spirit of a man. The Johnny Walker Collection. Sportswear and accessories.
Napoleon.
Mon empereur, we cannot wait for Waterloo to dry. We must attack now.
Cellular One's led the way in wireless phone service from the start. And while we got it to you as quickly as possible, just think if we'd gotten it to you sooner.
Okie dokie.
Sign up now and get 50% off our lowest rate plan and pay just $4.97 a month.
Introducing a sports sedan that sets a new standard of performance and a touring sedan that sets a new standard of luxury. Here they are. Introducing the new TL with the satellite link navigation system from Acura.
Complete Cubs coverage right after the game on NBC5 Chicago.
Night baseball in the postseason at Wrigley Field. Ryan Klesko starts it off. He struck out against Wood his first time up. An off-season in terms of power for Klesko. He hit just 18 home runs. But he had the game one grand slam in this series. 2-0. Through the first three innings, Wood threw 59 pitches. Maddux, who is not only excellent but economical, needed just 25 to work the first three. 3-0. That one's in there.
Ryan Klesko likes the ball down and out over the plate. His long swing could be a problem against Wood.
Can't catch up with a 3-1 pitch, full count.
And if you can't hit the 3-1 fastball, you definitely, you know, have problems sometimes when you get behind the count two strikes. But he has a little longer swing, and it seems like he swings a little harder than he should against Wood.
Left field, Rodriguez toward the line, into the corner, fair ball, and he's got it. Right up against the 355 sign.
Well, when a guy throws as hard as Kerry Wood does, you don't swing harder, you just swing quicker. You have to get the bat through the hitting zone quicker, not harder. That was a good pitch there by Kerry Wood, and good, actually a good swing by Klesko to do as much as he did with it. Without the wind, that ball might have gone out. So he thought he hit it well enough to get it out. It was a pitch moving down and away, and he went out there and got it.
Andrew Jones walked his first time, and Gaetti can't handle it. Big turn by Jones, and now he returns to first. Let's see how they score it. Took a tough hop on Gary.
Well, it's a breaking ball. He was out in front of it, and I think that's what fooled him. The speed, he thought it was hit harder than it was because he had a chance to move one step forward, and he did not move, but he thought it was hit harder.
E5. Jones at first with one out for Eddie Perez, who struck out in the second. 1-0 Atlanta as they bat in the fourth. Trying to sweep the divisional series for the third straight year. Inside, ball one. Michael Tucker will be next.
A lot of people think of Eddie Perez as Greg Maddux's personal catcher, and we've seen over the years a lot of catchers who catch certain pitchers, and people wonder why.
Here he goes. And Houston can't come up with it, so he can't make a throw. Andrew Jones steals second base.
Well, he actually had a real good jump. So he takes off the moment Kerry Wood makes his first move. And even with a good throw, I don't think they were going to get Andrew Jones. And Houston trying to rush his throw.
Now the 2-0 pitch to Perez. Runs inside, 3-0.
And Bob, the reason you like a catcher, certain catchers like to work with certain pitchers and vice versa, is because they think alike. Their patterns are similar. And a pitcher doesn't like to have to shake a catcher off a lot because it gives a hitter a chance to understand what is coming.
3-0 pitch, in for a strike. There's Javi Lopez, game two hero. Along with Glavine, who pitched well, and Chipper Jones, who knocked home the game winner. Full count now.
And Bobby Cox was quick to point out to me that some of Greg Maddux's greatest games earlier were caught by Javi Lopez. So he knows that they can work together. It's just that Maddux prefers Perez.
Jones at second with one out, and the 3-2 pitch got him. That's four for Kerry Wood. And coming up tomorrow night.
Sunday at 8, 7 Central. Jessica Lange, Liam Neeson. His courage led a nation to freedom.
And we'll have justice.
Rob Roy, NBC Sunday.
That's the network premiere of Rob Roy tomorrow. They're going to walk Michael Tucker intentionally with first base open and take their chances with Maddux.
More and more managers have a tendency to pitch to the eighth place hitter and try to get the pitcher to start off the next inning. But it cost them in Atlanta in this situation. Tucker hit a two-run homer. So now they've learned their lesson and they've decided that they're not going to mess with him in this situation again.
Maddux doubled and scored in the third. Helps himself with the bat and with the glove. He's won 8 consecutive gold gloves as the best fielding pitcher in the league. Strike one.
As good as Kerry Woods is and athletic as he is, it'd be tough for him to win gold gloves because he's a power pitcher, and power pitchers fall off the mound and they're not in great fielding position after they throw the baseball.
0-2. I'm reminded of Bob Gibson when you say that, the way he used to fall off the mound, but he was such a good athlete, he fielded his position well in spite of it.
Well, good point. He was a rare exception.
Here's the 0-2. And he makes quick work of Maddux to get out of the inning with his 5th strikeout. To the bottom of the 4th, 1-0 Braves.
Something powerful is happening. More powerful than Ford or Dodge. It's the truck, and it's coming.
South Florida, a true story. A man was out walking one day when he discovered a bag filled with jewelry. When no one claimed it, he ended up with over $1 million. When it comes to retirement, you can depend on luck or you can depend on us, Sun America. Ask about our personal retirement portfolios and don't leave your future to chance. Sun America, the retirement specialist.
The worst was I'd be at a party and someone would light up a cigarette and that cigarette would look like filet mignon to me. My mouth would practically water. Without Nicorette gum, I could never have quit. I could chew a piece when I needed it, and I would regain control, and it would soothe my cravings fast. After a piece of Nicorette, a cigarette would only look like top round to me, and that I could resist.
Nicorette gum helps you fight your cravings, your habit, your way. You can do it. Nicorette can help.
NBC's coverage of tonight's Division Series game is brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. By Gatorade Thirst Quencher. You either have it in you or you don't. Life is a sport. Drink it up. By Claritin. And by Sun America, the retirement specialist.
Maddux will face the 3-4 and 5 hitters in the Chicago fourth, beginning with Sosa. Low and away for ball one. Sammy lined to right his first time up. Congregate on Waveland. Sammy doesn't get it. 1-1.
Well, Sammy, just a little impatient here. I mean, that pitch is way out of the strike zone. There's no way you can hit that. One of the things that he has accomplished this year is he had become more patient. The other thing he did, he moved off the plate and lowered his bat, which he says lets him view the ball better, gives him a better view of the pitch. And that's one of the reasons he felt he could see the ball better this year.
1-2.
But if Greg Maddux finds a weakness, he will exploit it. And you see, neither of these two pitches have been strikes.
Well, look where Perez sets up.
Sets up as a ball.
Not yet. He may shift over as Maddux gets ready. There he goes. Bounces that one up there. 2-2. One of the keys with Maddux isn't just his great location, but the late movement he has on his pitches. It seems like his pitches almost slide off your bat.
Well, that's a good term to use and think about in the future.
Full count.
Well, it seems like they're there, and then all of a sudden they do move. Well, you see Perez set up outside.
The payoff pitch gets him. It was a foul tip back into Perez's glove. And he got Sammy to swing at what might have been ball four.
Well, let's take a look at these pitches. First one was a ball. That was a ball. This is a ball. Another ball. He does not throw a strike in this at bat to Sammy. Now watch. This is ball four.
If Greg ball one to Grace.
If he finds out you will swing his pitches out of the strike zone, he will continue to throw them out of the strike zone.
Sammy probably figured that was about as close to a strike as he was going to get from Maddux. So he wailed away. Big cut and a miss from Grace.
That's the Greg Maddux changeup. That's the most feared pitch for a left-handed hitter from Greg Maddux.
Grace and Maddux were, of course, Chicago Cub teammates for many years. Played together on the 89 NL East winners. Two and two. The first of Maddux's 18 postseason starts was for the Cubs against the Giants, and he was bombed here at Wrigley Field 11-3. Things have gotten better for him since. He won the first of his four Cy Young Awards wearing a Cub uniform in 92. Center field, Jones. That's the second out. The MetLife blimp, Snoopy One, is providing a bird's eye view of tonight's playoff action. Look to the skies for Snoopy and the MetLife blimp. Now, in truth, if you do that all around the country, only a very few of you will actually see it. I'm guessing they don't have one over every city and town in America, so you might be wasting your time. Don't take that advice literally. Here's Rodriguez, who had a double his first time up. Broken bat and a pop back of short. Coming in from left field is Klesko, and Maddux slices through the heart of the Chicago order in the fourth. They go down 1-2-3 and still trail it 1-0.